Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. And there has been a lot of requests for the facial recognition videos, so I thought why not, let's make it. And there are two approaches that we are going to see here in this video itself. So the first one, that was one of the highly requested one, that was for the image files where you actually import an image and we see the facial recognition done there. And the second most important thing, and that was the most requested one, was for the webcam. So that also we are going to do it. And before moving on, I just want to tell you that there is a huge giveaway that is coming onto the channel. So please subscribe to the channel, hit the like button and follow my Instagram account. I'll be posting the information there about the giveaway so that you can win exciting gifts. So please don't miss out on this. And I would like to thank all of you for all the love and support. We are now a family of 2000 members, and for that, and for that reason itself, I just want to tell you that your support means a lot to me. So please do subscribe to the channel and please do follow me on Instagram for further details on the giveaway. Okay, so without wasting any more time, let's begin. So before moving forward to the video, I want you guys to install facial recognition, and I know most of you who have been following this channel already have. And if you haven't, then I think you can install here. I think the video link is should be here somewhere. And the next one I want you to check out is this video. This video actually will tell you like how you can apply your facial recognition algorithms into a particular video file, and how you can create a video where it actually shows the facial recognition points on the video, on the characters itself. Okay, so before moving forward, please make sure that you are well aware of these two videos and you have installed facial recognition and you have installed the CV2 module. Okay, so if you are done with all these things, then you are at the right place. Let's start. Okay, so let's start off with our first example code that we have for a simple image based face recognition, where you have to just feed the image of the person and see if we get the face recognized. Okay, so I have the image of myself here in the form of a screenshot. I'll just show you. Okay, let me just delete this. Okay, so I have this image. Okay, there's my face. Okay, so this is the face that I have, and I'll be using this image to check if the algorithm actually detects my face or not. Okay, so there's basically one simple example of how you can use face recognition to just supply a image and see if there are any faces that we can detect. Okay, so the code is very simple. I hope everyone has already installed Python CV2 module. If you haven't, then please watch the videos that I've already told you to watch. And the first important thing is to import the image that we have, that we need actually for the face recognition. And before that, actually you can import OS, that basically comes by default as everyone knows it. And you have to explicitly import CV2, which is basically the one that we are going to use for the face recognition. Okay, so the first important thing is to basically import the image that we need for the face recognition. So this one, image path. And the second important thing is to import the hrcascade file. So this is the hrcascade frontal face default.xml. And you might ask me why we are using it. And I want to tell you that this is the base of the image recognition for this example. Okay, and you might ask how. So, but I won't go into details, but you need to remember this very carefully. So please understand every bit that I'm saying right now. So hrcascade classifier is an object detection approach, which was proposed by Paul Viola and Michael Jones in their paper that they had submitted, which was named as Rapid Object Detection Using a Boosted Cascade of Simple Features, that was published in 2001. So I read this information in the IEEE abstract papers, which was posted by Paul Viola itself. I hope so. So what the idea with hrcascade is that it is a machine learning approach that actually trained a function against a lot of images to ultimately be able to determine and detect objects, like if it is a person or not, or whether it is a vehicle, or is it a building, or is it a tree. And these things have to be differentiated in ZBrain. And this was possible by the regressive input feedback in the form of the image and the image learning. Interesting, isn't it? We can actually learn more about this by reading the documentation that is already on the internet or Google. If you just Google it, you will be able to find it. But don't worry, we can have a separate session on this altogether. For now, just remember this will be used for object detection. Okay. So the next thing is cv2.imread, this one, where you are asking cv2 to read your image file, and then we take the image file and convert it into grayscale. Okay, by this line, where we use cv2.cvtColor. And mostly in face recognition, the algorithm is considered to detect more accurately on the linear color images, but that has been proved lately that it's not the case, but we are still using it, so we will be converting that into the grayscale. But you might ask, like, we have heard about RGB color format, but what is color BGR to gray, isn't it? So actually in CV2, the default color format in OpenCV is basically RGB, but its bytes are reversed, so that is why it is called as BGR. So if you know about the color formats, we have 24-bit colors, isn't it? So 8-bit red, 8-bit green, and 8-bit blue. But here in this case, what happens is it starts from 8-bit blue. So that is why it is a BGR. And the next important thing that we have here is this one. And here the face cascade dot detect multi scale. Actually, this is the function that detects objects of different sizes in the input image. And based on that, the objects are returned as a list of rectangles. Okay, and the scale factor that you see here, the scale factor. So the scale factor also specifies how much image size is reduced with each scale, as this is a factor. With every scale, it determines how much the image size is reduced. So as it is a cascade, there will be a lot of layers in which images will be scaled, and there will be a lot of face detected, or there will be a lot of face detection because of the resizing of the sliding window architecture that we have. And there might be a lot of false positives as well. So that actually can result in a lot of similar matches. And to mitigate that, we use the minimum neighbors. So with more minimum neighbors, you will be able to have more accuracy, and proper rectangles will be drawn on the face as it is detected. And minimum size, I think it is self-explanatory. It determines the size of the object. If the size of the object is less than 30 by 30, then we won't consider it into our matching. And next, as the face gives you the image point matrix that will be used for the creation of the rectangle, you pass the image, x and y coordinate, the height parameters, and the color of the rectangle. Here I have taken it as green, so this is the green color, and the border size that you have here is 2. Okay, so it will create a rectangle with color green with border size 2. So now I'll ask OpenCV to write the image file that it has detected on the name that I want to give to the file name. So by using imwrite, it will write the image to the file name, and that is how we'll get this image converted, and we'll have this file generated based on the facial recognition points that we have. So this file that we generate using CV2 will have the facial detection as per the experiment that we are going to perform. Okay, so we have to see whether my face is recognized properly or not. Okay, so the next thing that we want to do is we basically want to run this program and see whether we are getting the output or not. Okay. So here is the file that I have for face_photo.py. It already has me.jpg. So I have to just right click on this one, or else I can right click from here and run Python file in terminal. Okay. So now it has generated the output here. And if I click on this one, I should see the image. Yes, see. Now it is able to detect the face for me. Okay. And that actually works very good with single images, and both as well for the multi-face detection. So if I have already created one more file which already has a team.jpg where there are multiple faces, so I can run this code as well to check out a different photograph altogether. So I have taken this one team.jpg here, so there are multiple faces, right? So I can just run face_photo_team, which actually takes team.jpg as an input. So I'll just do a right click and I'll run Python run through terminal, and it will convert that into the team image. See, so it has detected 4 images, and there are some of the error cases that we have. So with accuracy definitions, we can actually correct them, but I have left it as it is now. So it is for you to actually determine how you want the facial detection to be. So that should be enough for now. Okay, so I hope that was interesting. So now let's move on to the second example, and let's see how we can do this with a webcam. But before moving forward, I want to remind you that we have a giveaway contest coming up. So please do follow me on Instagram and subscribe here. I will be sharing the details very soon, and I need your support on this. So please, please, please follow me on Instagram and do subscribe on the channel. Okay, so let's move on then.
Okay, so now the audio should be a bit better. Actually, I screwed up some of the settings on the audio, so I'm really sorry for that. So I hope all of you have seen the part 2 of the face recognition video, where we had worked with face recognition using a video file as an input. So previously we had used cv2.videocapture and the input was the file name of the video that we used. Okay, so this is the file name that we had previously used. So if you have seen the facial recognition part 2, you know what I'm talking about here. So, and the only difference here is instead of the video, we will use a webcam. And remember that when executing this program or the code that you have, your webcam should not be running already. Okay, so there should not be a process of the webcam already running. Otherwise, if you execute this program, it will not get executed properly and you might get issues. Okay, or you might face issues. So mostly that happens with the Logitech Capture, which actually is a third party application that you install from Logitech itself. So based on that, you might face some issues while running this code. So make sure your webcam is already not running. Okay, so here as well, we first start off with the input. We need a face recognition algorithm to encode our facial points, OpenCV to provide us with the input video that is going to be our webcam, NumPy to process nested arrays. And once again, if you haven't installed face recognition, then please install it. I have provided the link in the description and in the pinned comments below. So the next thing that we need is the image file, which will be used by our face recognition algorithm. This is the one. So these two are the faces that we need. So this is Captain Price's face and this is my face. So I have captured both of them and this is the input that we are going to need for the face recognition. And that is what we need here. And we need the image files, which will be used by our face recognition algorithm to generate the encoding values that will be compared with the face frame actually that is getting generated with the webcam to determine if there is a face match or not. So if yes, we will see the rectangle and the name attached to our beautiful faces, isn't it? So this is our step number one of encoding. Okay, so remember that this is the step one of encoding. So now let's get back to our explanation once again. By using OpenCV and Python, we render the input video feed that we have with cv2.videocapture. So here our input is our webcam and not the video file. And I am just giving you an example here. So think of this video as a feed from the webcam that is coming from the webcam. And then the video capture actually reads and generates each frame every time from the feed of the webcam until we stop it. And for each frame we generate using OpenCV, we repeat the encoding process using face recognition to generate the facial points. Okay, so with each frame that we get here, we actually do the encoding and then we take this encoding frame and compare it with the encoding frame that we had from our encoding step one. So this was a step two from the webcam that we have, the frame that we got, and we are encoding that. That is our step two. And the one that we had previously as an input and we had encoded that, that is our step one that I already told you. Okay, I hope you remember that. So we will do a comparison on both of them. And then we take the encoding frame and compare it with the encoded frame from the step one based on the desired tolerance value. Okay, and if there is a match, then we create a frame and a name text so that we can show that as a part of the frame. And this happens dynamically and it runs throughout the webcam feed. And every character that you add will go through the same cycle and you will see live face recognition using the webcam. Okay, that's the whole concept. Okay, so let's go back to the code. So now we have our two images that we have imported and we have passed it on to the face recognition algorithm to generate the face encoding, and we have added them to the list of the known faces. Okay, so why known faces? Because we want our webcam feed that is getting encoded to know that this encoding is already known to the user, and please detect them in your frame. Okay, so when we tell that and we ask the encoding framework to actually detect a known face, it needs a corresponding frame that has already been encoded. Okay, so that actually can help us to determine what name is the frame or the person that is in the frame itself. Okay, so now let's go to the actual part here. So there's the actual part. So here at videocapture.read, we read each frame and store the return value and the frame in the respective variables that are RET, frame. And then with cv2.resize that we have here, we have the frame 0, 0, fx 0.25, fy equal to 0.25. We actually resize the frame size either by reducing or increasing it. Mostly, we try and reduce it so that it renders properly. Okay, so here the parameter that we provide is the source frame and the interpolation values that are fx and fy that you see here to determine the scaling. Then we compute the RGB scale size of the resized frame, that is a smaller size of the frame. And here at the face recognition.face location that you see, we pass it to the algorithm to determine the face location points. And now as the face location points are detected and are ready, but to create the match, we need the face encoding based on which we will compare the values. So for that, we will encode it, and that is our step 2 encoding that I said. Then using this encoding that we are doing it here when we are comparing the faces based on the encoding that we have it here. So we'll then compare it. So then using the encoding values, we will compare it with the known faces encoding list. So this is the known faces encoding list and the values that we have to check if there are any matches using the face recognition.compare faces. Okay, so we'll use this based on the known faces list, and we will check whether this face encoding is inside one of those encodings that we have under known faces encoding. And this will take a parameter of tolerance that I have already told you, based on which we will determine how strict the facial comparison should be. So it is 0.6. So as low as you go, the more strict the comparisons will be. So as you can say, like, the lower you go, the stricter it gets. And we check if there is a match. Next, we need to find the face distance. And here we get the Euclidean distance for each comparison face that we have, which tells us how similar the faces are. And then we try to find the best image. And for that, we add the names that we find in the encoding to the list of values that we have, face underscore names, as they are detected. And post which, we just take the face value and create the rectangle box and give it a name. Okay, so here we take the names and the frame that we have, and we just create the rectangle and we create the name. Okay, so this is the font that we are using here for the name, and this is the frame, and we are providing what name we are trying to provide this. Okay, what the face has, and then we try to create the frame here, and we provide the font and the scale that we want. Okay, so here basically we create the font and the text, and we create the rectangle here, two rectangles. So this is for the big rectangle that we have, and this is for the bottom rectangle that actually stores the text in this one. Okay, and by using cv2.imshow, we show each frame on the screen just like this.
So as we had two faces, so what happens is I'll just pull up the face of Captain Price. And I'll show you like how it works. If you see here, see, and I'll just hit Q to actually exit it. I think this was fun, isn't it? And the code is already available here, so you can go here and check the code out. This is the one that we had run it. So engine.py, which is basically our webcam based project that we have done now. And the other one that we had is face photo. So you can use that as well. So this is just for the single face. And this one, the images, I think already you have to put the images in this folder here. I have not supplied any face of screenshot of mine, so don't worry about that. And this is the hard cascade frontal face default.xml that you can use, and all this is available here, and the code link is already given in the description, so you can make use of it. And many of you actually are facing issues while cloning the repository. So if you are not able to do a git, or if you're not able to do a git hyphen hyphen version in your terminal, then you don't have git installed in your machine. So what you have to do is you have to just go to git bash. Okay, you have to just go to git bash, and there's git hyphen downloads that you have. So https://git-scm.com/downloads, and here you can select one of the platforms that you're currently using, and if you are on Windows, then click on this Windows and you can download it, or else you can click on this as well and download it. And once you have installed it, it will be available to you, and you will be able to do the git clone commands that you are facing, and you won't face actually the problems that you're getting, like git is not recognized as a valid command or something. Okay, you won't get this issue. Don't worry about that, and you will be able to clone it. Okay, and I have explained the steps on how you can clone the repository in the part 2 of the face recognition video, so please do check out that and let me know how it works. Okay, so I hope it was interesting enough for you guys. Actually, we learned two new techniques actually for face recognition, so one with the image file and the other one was with the webcam. So I hope you enjoyed it, and do please try them out. Okay, and make sure that you try them out on your own by using the code that you have. Code is available everywhere, and as I have already told you several times, code, you can get it from everywhere. You can Google it, you can do it from your friends, or you can get it from any of the sources that you like, but understanding the code is really important. So make sure that you understand it before you do it, because when you're trying to get to use that in your project, there'll be some conditions that you will not understand if you haven't understood the actual flow and the concept itself. Okay, so make sure that you understand how the code works, and then you can basically go ahead and implement in your projects, or you can use it for fun, whatever you want. Okay, so but make sure that you subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and please comment on what you liked, what you didn't, and make sure please that you follow me on Instagram. I'm going to announce the giveaway there as well as on the channel, so please make sure that you follow me both the places. Okay, one on Instagram and the other one on YouTube as well. Okay, so I'll meet you in the next one. And if you have any suggestions, or if you want me to make any other videos, then please put them in the comment section below. I'll try to make them. So until next time, it's Pythoholic signing off.